TikTok apparently has a new gym bag essential, the Hypochlorous Acid Spray. And as a member of Gen X, I find myself smiling saying, I have seen that one before. But I am not mad seeing it gain traction again as used correctly and for the right candidate. Hypochlorous Acid can be an incredibly useful addition to both your workout gear and your general skincare routine. So let's talk about what it is, what it does, and which skin conditions it works best for. And quite important, what not to mix it with when you do your routine. Welcome back to my channel. I'm Dr. Anne, medical doctor here to teach you how to best take care of your skin and general well-being. Hypochlorous acid is a weak acid with strong antimicrobial properties, meaning it will work against bacteria, fungi, and to some degree even viruses. It can be used as surface disinfectant, but very important is not bleach. Hypochlorous acid is HOCl, an acidic chlorine disinfectant, and bleach is hypochlorite or OCl-, so alkaline chlorine, and while both can be present in the same solution to a certain degree, which one is more common depends on pH and manufacturing process. Not to mention that one will help you with your skin issues while the other one might give you chemical burns. Hypochlorous acid in its use in skincare isn't actually new. It was discovered back in 1834 by the French chemist Antoine Jérôme Ballard and gained a lot of popularity during World War I and II to treat wounds. In the 1940s, it was also nebulized in hospitals as a means to control the spread of airborne pathogens. This information led to a surge in popularity during the COVID pandemic, with sadly a corresponding increase of calls to the poison control center, as some quite prominent figures couldn't quite grasp the before mentioned difference between hypochlorous acid and bleach. Historical lessons aside, hypochlorous acid is not bleach, but an acidic chlorine disinfectant, safe to use on the skin and used for skin disinfection for more than 150 years now. So why put it in your gym bag? Hypochlorous acid is directly toxic for many bacteria and fungi due to oxidizing and destroying their cell membrane. It also reduces the activity of histamine, leukotriene B4 and interleukin 2, which means it is anti-inflammatory and can reduce itching. We now know that our neutrophils produce hypochlorous acid when activated by an invader. It is essentially part of our body's own immune response, meaning our body is well adapted to it and the substance will not affect and destroy our skin cells, just the microorganisms. This mechanism of action also means that there is no potential for bacteria developing resistance to it like it can to antibiotics. It will not stop working all of a sudden. Looking at the mechanism of action, antimicrobial, anti-inflammatory and antipruritus, which is a fancy way of saying anti-itch, it is easy to say which skin conditions it is best for. Anything that is caused by unwanted microorganisms on the skin, inflammatory and or itchy skin conditions will benefit most from incorporating hypochlorous acid in their routine. Think acne, eczema, rosacea or atopic dermatitis. Reducing the microbial load, be it cutibacterium acne or demodex mites, might help alleviate symptoms. Calming the inflammation will help the overall appearance of these skin conditions, and reducing itch is a huge thing for those affected by it as well. Please note that hypochlorous acid has not been tested as a drug, so you can't make any drug claims. Hypochlorous acid is not an acne treatment. It is skincare, cosmetics. That doesn't mean it won't work. It just means that I would always recommend using it alongside a routine targeting the skin condition you are struggling with, not as the main thing. There's also no guarantee that it will work, so best test it for a few weeks if you think you might benefit from it, and then reevaluate how it has been for your skin. The good news is that it has barely any side effects, so you don't have to overthink the whole process. Hypochlorous acid isn't drying. It has barely any irritation potential, and good news for those with towels ruined by benzoyl peroxide, will not bleach fabrics. You can obviously be allergic to anything, so patch test, but most people, even those with sensitive skin, get along very well with the ingredient. Again, I can't stress enough that it needs to be properly manufactured. I know that you can buy DIY kits from online retailers, but I personally, knowing my chemistry skills, wouldn't risk getting it wrong and burning my face off in the process. You can use it for as long as you want and how often you want without fearing overdosing. The best way to incorporate hypochlorous acid into your routine depends on the effect you want it to have. If you want to use it to help with a chronic skin condition like acne, rosacea or atopic dermatitis, it is recommended to be used daily or even twice daily after cleansing and before you apply your other products. As it works by oxidation, you should let it dry completely first so it doesn't disturb the rest of your products. If your skin is good already and your main goal is to keep it that way, you can use it in situations where you know you should cleanse your skin properly after a sweaty workout, if you've been wearing a face mask and can feel sweat and bacteria underneath it, but can't remove your makeup for a good cleanse. All that are situations when misting our face with a hypochlorous acid spray might be helpful. It is also often used to treat minor wounds, fresh piercing and tattoos, or to prevent body acne in people that work out a lot, which is why it quickly became a gym bag essential. You can pair it with anything if you let it completely dry before you follow up with the rest of your routine. It works by oxidizing, so if you apply it and directly follow up with your antioxidant serum, you will reduce the effect of both. Hypochlorous acid is a cosmetic, not a drug, so if you have acne, medical treatments like prescription retinoids, salicylic acid, azelaic acid, and maybe antibiotics or other oral medication will most likely be more effective. But as compared to these things, it is non-drying and with low irritation potential, it might be a good supporting act in your treatment plan. If you are on prescription, you should of course always discuss any additional product with your prescribing doctor. And if you enjoyed this video, you will most likely enjoy the ones linked on the screen here. Don't forget to check out the description box for everything else I have to offer, and like and subscribe to this channel so you don't miss the next video.